of love.
Yes.
Lend the crown. Lend the crown.
I'm going to ask all those who can stand, please stand for the reading of Scripture. Be coming from 2 Timothy, chapter 1, verse 5. And then we go over to 2 Timothy, verse 3, 14 and 15. And it reads, "When I call to remembrance the unfeigned faith that is thee, in thee, which..." "Which dwelt first in thy grandmother..." "Which dwelt first in thy grandmother, Lois, and the mother, Eunice, and I am persuaded that in thee also..." And then we'll swing over to chapter 3, 14 and 15. And it reads, "And that from a child thou hast known the Holy Scriptures, which are able..."
Second Timothy.
It reads what? "But continue thou in the things which thou hast learned and hast been assured of, knowing of whom thou hast learned them, and that from a child thou hast known the Holy Scriptures, which are able to make these wise unto salvation through faith which is in Christ Jesus."
Amen.
Now I read 2 Timothy. "Let the word be a blessing to the doers and the hearers of his word."
Pray for me.
Go ahead.
As we humble ourselves now before Almighty God, I'd like to ask you to please. Humble yourselves in his presence. Open your heart, your mind, and your soul to receive him and call upon his holy name. Heavenly Father, we stand before you today. We thank you for all that you've done for us and for all that you're doing for us. You brought us through this horrible COVID-19, and we're still standing here.
Yes.
We thank you, Father, for the days that you've allowed us to be here. You woke us up this morning. You started us on our way. As we stand before you this morning, Lord God, we understand your absolute magnificent character, a character of love, a character of forgiveness. You are a second chance, God. So if we confess our sins to you, you're faithful to forgive us and cleanse us of all unrighteousness. What a God we serve. What a God we serve. Father, we ask you to stop by here today. Touch us this morning and hold us close to you. And keep us, Heavenly Father, forever in your mercy and grace and love. We stand before you to God knowing that you are an almighty God who spoke everything into existence. You loved us so much that you sent your son to die for us. And here we stand today, Father, open our heart, our mind, and our soul. You said that if we would humble ourselves before you and seek your face and turn from our wicked ways, that you would forgive us of our sins. So, Father, we stand today asking for forgiveness, asking for your love, mercy, and care. Thank you for all that you've done for us, Lord. Bless us now as we proceed through this day. Touch this church with your love. Bless every ministry in this church. Let us move closer and closer to bring them more close to your kingdom. We thank you for all that you are. We thank you for all that you do. And we thank you for your everlasting love. In the name of Jesus, I pray this prayer. Thank you, Lord. 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 Amen.
I got a new home.
Go ahead.
Over in Zion. And it's mine, mine, oh mine.
Yeah.
I got a new home over in Zion. And it's mine, oh mine. I got a new home. Over in Zion,
Zion,
and it's mine, mine, oh mine,
oh mine.
I got a new home. Over in Zion, and it's mine, it's mine, oh mine. I got a new walk. It's over in Zion, and it's mine, it's mine, it's mine. Oh, I got a new walk. Oh, it's over in Zion, and it's mine, it's mine, oh mine. I got a new home. It's over in Zion,
Zion,
and it's mine, it's mine, it's mine. I got a new home over in Zion, and it's mine, it's mine, it's mine.
Brothers and sisters, we thank you for raising your voices, opening your hearts to the Lord. We thank you as a deacon ministry that we will have a blessed week, a blessed day, and a blessed year. Go with the Lord. Amen.
Good morning, church. Y'all could do better than that. Good morning, church. Amen, amen. We just want to thank God for waking us up. See all the lovely mass places in the place. Can we wave to one another? Good morning. Hey. Hey, Lady Steph. Hey, Reverend Riley. Amen, amen, amen. We just thank God for waking us up. We thank God for giving us traveling mercy and grace. We please humble ourselves as we pray. Dear God, we come to you now as humble as we are. We thank you for waking us up today. We thank you for all that you've done, and we thank you for what you're going to do. We thank you for everything. We pray that you allow us to follow your path, follow your steps. We just thank you. We pray that you allow the Holy Spirit to move through us, move through our service, move through our pastor. Give our pastor the courage and the right words to say. Thank you. We love you on this lovely morning. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Is there anybody that just came to praise the name of Jesus this morning? Hallelujah. Come on, if you came to praise the name of Jesus, stand on your feet. Just wanna praise you forever and ever and ever, yeah, for all you've done for me. Blessings and glory and honor
and honor,
they all belong.
They all belong to you.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Oh, for blessing.
For blessing me.
Come on, say right there. I just wanna
praise you.
Come on, put your hands together.
Forever.
Forever. Sings and
blessings and glory
and honor
and honor,
they all belong
to you.
Thank you Jesus
for blessing me.
Oh,
I just wanna praise you.
Come on, put your hands together. Sing it
forever
and ever.
you're thankful. Yeah. Come on, if you're thankful, lift your hands up and bless the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. How many people love him more than anything? Hallelujah. More than anything I can ever attain. Hallelujah. More than my house, more than my car, Lord. I love you. I love you, God, because you woke me up this morning and started me on my way. Hallelujah. Oh, I lift my hand in total adoration to you. You reign on the throne.
Yes, yes.
For you are God and God alone. Because of you, my cloudy days are gone. I can sing to you this song. I just wanna say that I love you more than anything. Praise him, help me sing it. Say I lift my hands in total.
Come on, let's worship.
Adoration
unto you.
You reign upon the throne.
You reign on the throne.
Hallelujah. For you are God. Jesus.
You reign on the throne.
For you are God.
Thank you. True love. I hope everybody's having a wonderful Sunday so far. This is our time to acknowledge guests, and we would like to acknowledge our virtual guests as well, because you guys still matter, and we are glad that you chose us to be with this morning, because you could have been anywhere else. So when I call your name, I would like you to stand. Lindsay Harrington and Diane Harrington. The ushers will be giving you something, and we thank you for being here, and I hope everybody has a blessed week.
Praise the Lord. I can use this one. Amen. Praise the Lord. To those of you who are visiting, amen. Do we have any other visitors? Maybe you did not sign in today. Please, that we might recognize you. Any other visitors in the house? Hallelujah. Praise God. Amen. We just wanted to acknowledge you. That's not to bring any attention to embarrass you, but we just want to acknowledge you and let you know we are so grateful that you are our special guest today. Amen. There, we know we're not crazy. We know that there are other churches throughout this valley that you could have gone and you could have graced their doorstep, but today God brought you here, and we're so grateful that your face is in the place. Amen. And so we pray that something will be said, something will be sung, something will be prayed that will speak to your spirit and speak to your heart today, that you'll feel especially warm today and know that you're in the right place at the right time. Amen. And if by chance you are looking for a church home, we pray that your search is over today and that you choose true love, that God moves you once again to become a part of this church family. But if by chance you are a member of another local church, another church home, we want you to take all of our greetings and our love back with you to your church home and to your pastor. Tell them that we said hello, that we love you, and amen. We did our best to try to treat you like family today. Right. Amen. To God be the glory. Well, my sisters and brothers, amen. We have moved to that part of our service now for our tithes and offerings. Amen. 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 In the Gospels, we read the story of the feeding of the 5,000. And Jesus asked his disciples, he said, get them something to eat. And they said, well, it's going to take a lot of money to feed all these people. And so Jesus said, well, you give them something to eat. And they went around and they found a little boy and they got his lunch, 2 fishes and 5 barley loaves. And Jesus then took it and he blessed it, he broke it, and he gave it to his disciples and said, give it to all of them. Had them sit down, and check this out, had them to sit down on little grassy knolls. They're out in the desert. Who but God can turn a desert place into a campground? Oh, bless his holy name. And not only do we see that in the text, but the Bible says that Jesus fed 5,000 men plus women and children. Amen. I want you to know that even if you only have that which is equivalent to the widow's mites, God can always take your little and God can do a lot with it. Well, preacher, I don't have very much to give. I don't have very much to contribute. Just know our ushers are passing through the aisles right now if you need an envelope. Amen. But just know that whatever you have to give today, whatever you have to contribute to the upbuilding of God's kingdom here on earth, that God will take your little and God can do a lot. You know, my sisters and brothers, we oftentimes say, well, I don't have enough to give. I don't have enough to give. I'll wait till I get some more and then I'll be able to give to the Lord. Again, God will take your little and God can do a lot with it. But I need for you to understand, this is a move of faith. A move of faith to be able to give, amen, to what God is doing in the kingdom. You see, it doesn't take a whole lot of faith if you got a whole lot of money. Hello? Because all you're doing, amen, amen. Because oftentimes when we have a whole lot, we're giving in reaction or response to what is being said. But when you only have a little and you don't know where the rest is going to come from and you still give anyway, that's an act of faith. God honors your faith, not your reaction. Hello? Amen. And to be able to stand in faith and know that no matter what you have, that God will never leave you nor forsake you. David said, I've been young and now I'm old. I've never seen the righteous forsaken, nor his seed begging bread. Amen. Again, our ushers have passed through the aisles. If you need an envelope, if by chance you've already got an envelope, amen, we want to let you know that there are three other ways that you can give. You can go to our website at www.truelovembclv.com. And click on the give tab and you can give electronically that way, or you can go to our app and you can go to the app, the Church One app and Ministry One app, excuse me, Ministry One app, and find True Love Missionary Baptist Church there, and then you can just follow all the prompts and make your contribution. The fourth way, of course, is you can get an envelope and place your offering, your contribution in an envelope and send it to True Love Missionary Baptist Church, 1941 North 8th Street, Las Vegas, Nevada, 89106. Amen. At this time, do we have a youth that's supposed to be praying over our offering? Praise God. Yes. Amen. I'm young at heart. Amen. Can I pray for the offering? Hallelujah. Let's look to God in prayer. Father God, in the name of Jesus, we thank you and praise you, God, just for this moment, this opportunity to give. We thank you, Lord God, for an opportunity, Lord God, to participate in what you're doing in our midst, what you're doing in this season, what you're doing in the world. God, we pray, Lord God, that you'll take these gifts, the gifts of a few and bless many. We thank you, Lord God, for an opportunity to give. We thank you for those who have a desire but nothing to contribute. We pray that even they, Lord God, you will bless them, Father, in the name of Jesus, so that, Lord God, the next opportunity to give, they'll be able to do so. But all of us, Lord God, no matter what we contribute, no matter what we place in a plate, a basket, or a receptacle, this day, Lord God, we understand, God, that if we don't have a dime, we at least have the sacrifice of praise. So, God, we thank you. We thank you in advance. We thank you, Lord God, in Jesus' name. Amen and amen. You may take your seats in the presence of the Lord. Praise God. We have, amen, a musical selection. And then we're going to have our praise dance ministry.
At the wounds that give me life, Grace flowing from his side, no greater sacrifice. What he's done, all the glory and the honor to the Son. My sins are forgiven, my future is heaven. I praise God for what he's done. Sing for the freedom he has won. Even death is dead and done. His life has overcome. Oh, speak. Say the name above all names, over every broken place. He is risen from the grave. What he's done, what he's done, yeah. All the glory and the honor to the Son. My sins are forgiven, my future is heaven. I praise God for what he's done. What he's done. What he's done. All the glory and the honor to the Son. My sins are forgiven, my future is heaven. I praise God for what he's done. And now, on a throne of majesty, the Father's will complete. He reigns in victory. Oh, sing hallelujah to the King. He is worthy to receive all the worship we can bring. What he's done, what he's done. All the glory and the honor to the Son. My sins are forgiven, my future is heaven. I praise God for what he's done.
Good morning, church. My name is Dorothea Hollins. Say your name.
Hey, church. My name is Michael Galvin.
And we'll be reading Caged Bird by Maya Angelou. A free bird leaps on the back of the wind and floats downstream till the current ends, and dips his wing in the orange sun rays and dares to claim the sun. The sky. But a bird that stalks down his narrow cage can seldom see through his bars of rage. His wings are clipped and his feet is tied, so he opens his throat to sing. The caged bird sings with the fearful trill of things unknown but belongs to for still. And his tune is heard on the distant hill, for the caged bird sings of freedom.
The free bird thinks of another breeze, and the trade winds soft through the siding trees, in the fat warms waiting on a dawn bright lawn, and he names the sky of his own. But a caged bird stands on the grave of dreams. His shadow shouts on a nightmare scream. His wings are clipped and his feet are tied, so he opens his throat to sing. The caged bird sings with a fearful thrill of things unknown but long for still. And his tune is heard on the distant hill, for the caged bird sings of freedom.
That was The Caged Bird by Maya Angelou.
Waiting all Sometimes I feel like a murderous child. Sometimes I feel like a murderous child. Sometimes I feel like a murderous child. Long way.
Everybody clap your hands like this.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah.
Repeat after me.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah.
My turn.
We're blessed in the city. We're blessed in the field, yeah. We're blessed when we come and when we go. We cast down every stronghold, sickness and poverty must cease. Oh, for the devil is defeated. We are blessed. Help me sing. We're blessed in the city. We're blessed in the field. We're blessed when we come, when we, yeah, we pass down every stronghold. Whoa, 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 oh, devil is defeated. We are blessed. And again, we're blessed in the city. We're blessed. We're blessed. We're for the devil, for the we are. We gotta play the game. Hey, yeah, 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 yeah.
time, and even seeing God turn it around for you. Hallelujah. Weeping may endure for a night, but joy comes in the morning. Is that somebody's testimony? Well, God's turned everything around. You felt like giving up. Things were hard. You were challenged. You were pushed beyond the brink. But is there somebody here that knows all you had to do was wait 24 hours and God turned it around and around and around. And he's still turning things for you. Hallelujah. So that's an encouragement to somebody else today. Don't you throw in the towel. Don't you give up. Don't you give in. Because God will turn it around. Hallelujah. He'll turn it around and around.
And around. And around.
And around.
Come on, put those blessed hands together. Come on, bless him, bless him. Oh, magnify the Lord with me. And let us exalt his name together. Amen. Let's look to God in prayer. Our Father and our God, we thank you. We thank you, Lord God, in your ability, Lord God, your faithfulness to turn things around for us. Lord God, just this past week in Bible study, we were studying from the book of Acts, the 16th chapter, and there Paul and Silas were sitting in a dark, cold prison cell. And Lord God, the Bible says around midnight, they were praying and singing songs to you. And Lord God, before they could even close out one song, the earth quaked and shook the foundation. Lord God, their shackles fell off. The doors of their prison cell flew open because you're the God that turns things around. Thank you, God, in the name of Jesus. And there's somebody here today, Lord God, under the sound of my voice, they just needed to be reminded today that you are the God who turns things around. That no matter what their life is looking like right now, no matter what they're feeling in their bodies, you are the God who turns things around. And so, Lord God, I prophesy now in the name of Jesus. I declare and decree that right now, every person that donned this doorstep today, no matter what they came in, Lord God, feeling, no matter what they were going through, Lord God, before they came in this place, by the time they leave, Lord God, by the time the benediction has been uttered, God, you will have already turned things around. Bills that they didn't think they could pay, you're turning it around. Aches and pains, Lord God, that they thought, Lord God, would be wrecking their body all day long. Even right now, you're turning it around, Lord God. Father God, in the name of Jesus, God, we bless you and praise you. Marriages, Lord God, that seem like they're on the rocks right now. And people, Lord God, they've already got divorce papers, Lord God, but you're tearing the papers up right now because you're turning it around. You're restoring homes. You're restoring love. Oh, God, in the name of Jesus, Lord God, give peace, Lord God, where there's chaos. Lord God, bring an answer where all they have is questions. Restore, Lord God. Heal, Lord God, in the name of Jesus. And Lord God, I pray now that, Lord God, as we gather around the feet of your throne, Father God, in the name of Jesus, use me now mightily. Sit me down and let Jesus now stand up in my body. Lord God, take control of my mind and take control of my mouth. That only your word will go forth. And God, because we know it goes forth and will not return unto you void, then Lord God, even right now, Lord God, you're turning things around. In Jesus' name, amen. Come on and bless God again. Come on and bless the Lord. That's good for Dr. Hemphill, but will you bless the Lord? Hallelujah. Amen. Last week you were clapping and shouting and screaming for the Chiefs and for the Eagles, but would you give God some praise today? Hallelujah. Will you help me raise the roof and give God a hallelujah, a glory to God. Oh, magnify. Hallelujah. 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 Just in a few months, somebody's going to go see Beyonce, amen, and you're going to be shouting and praying. Oh, my God. People are going to tell you, would you hold it down? And you're not going to listen to them, but would you give God praise in his house? Beyonce didn't do nothing for you. Beyonce didn't save your soul. Hello? You got to pay for parking and a ticket. An outfit, get your hair done, get your nails did. Hello, somebody. Just to go see Beyonce. Don't shortchange God. Hallelujah. My sisters and brothers, I praise God for one more time to be able to stand before you and to be able to declare the word of God. A word comes to us today from the book 2 Timothy, amen, chapter 1, verse 5, and then we're going to skip over to chapter 3, verses 14 through 15, amen. It is our custom to stand for the word of God. If you're able to stand, please do so, amen. If you're not, amen, it's all right. You just stay right there, amen. Just read along with us. Praise God. As you know, we are continuing our sermon series, Family Matters. We're in a family series this month. We're actually going from first Sunday in this month of February to first Sunday in the month of March. We're preaching a sermon series under the title Family Matters. So we're going to continue. This is part 3. Amen. 2 Timothy chapter 1, verse 5. Then we're going to skip over to chapter 3, verses 14 through 15. Would y'all read with me today? Amen, amen. I am reminded of your sincere faith, which first lived in your grandmother Lois and in your mother Eunice, and I am persuaded now lives in you also. Chapter 3, verse 14 and 15. But as for you, continue in what you have learned and have become convinced of, because you know those from whom you learned it, and how from infancy you have known the Holy Scriptures, which are able to make you wise for salvation through faith in Christ Jesus. Amen. As you go to your seats on this Youth Empowerment Sunday, I want to preach for a little while from the thought I get from my mama. Amen. 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 I get it from my mom. I'm going to ask that you would keep your Bibles open, and I'm also going to ask that you would just take some copious notes where you need to take notes. I don't have any points to share with you. The point of the matter is, or the point of the sermon in its entirety is, I got it from my mama. Amen. Amen. So you'll find some things that will ring your bell, something that will speak to your spirit today. And so go ahead and write notes where you need to write notes. Amen. And if by chance you need to, don't worry. It's going to be on the internet, so you can go back and catch what you missed if you can't look over on your neighbor's paper. Amen. Amen. I get it from my mama. I need for you to understand, sisters and brothers, that Apostle Paul is in jail again. he was suddenly arrested, and he has been charged for being a disciple of the Lord Jesus Christ. My God, my God. That's preaching already there. Amen. He's arrested for being a disciple of the Lord Jesus Christ. And I'm just going to stop and meddle there for a moment. It's not even in my notes. Would you be found guilty of being a disciple of the Lord Jesus Christ? Now understand, this is not only his final letter, but also his final days, because in a few days, Paul would be executed under the hand of Nero. Paul has now reached the sunset of his ministry, and he gives final words of encouragement and exhortation to his son in the ministry, his son in the faith, Timothy. And understand, these are not only Paul's final words to Timothy, but they are representative of his final written words to all believers who hang on his penmanship about faith in God through Christ Jesus. In this letter, Paul personally addresses Timothy. The first letter had more of a pastoral or ecclesiastical tone, but this letter is totally personal. The first letter dealt more with church order and the handling of false teaching, and though this is addressed as well in the letter, Paul had to make more of an impact on his son in ministry. Paul first met Timothy as a young child in Lystra. It was on the first missionary journey to Lystra that Timothy was converted, but it was on his second and third missionary journeys that Timothy became his protege, his son in the faith, his assistant. And as was true with Jesus and his disciples, so it is also true of Paul and Timothy. After spending so much time with somebody, traveling and talking and walking, eating and sleeping and so forth, you really do get to know the one that you're with. During that time, Paul learned some things about Timothy. He learned that Timothy was steeped in the faith. He knew the scriptures and had a mixed parenting. What are you talking about there? You see, Timothy's daddy was a Greek and his mama was a Jew who had been converted under Christianity. His daddy was Greek, but his daddy wasn't saved. Y'all hang on to that now. And understand as well that Timothy was a vessel well receiving of Paul's instruction. But let me just make a parenthetical pit stop right there, Mother Minnie, to say to somebody who's been told that you were an illegitimate child. You knew I was going there. Don't you receive it? Don't you repeat it? And don't you believe it? Timothy's mother and father may have had an illegitimate relationship and marriage whereby their union was unlawful and frowned upon by society, but at no time was Timothy an illegitimate child. Mama and daddy may have messed up in a hookup, but God intended for Timothy to be born. And while I'm on it, I need to encourage somebody who's been led to feel that way all of your life. You were not a mistake. Glory to God. You are not a mistake. Even though mama and daddy may not have planned you, God knows the plans that he has for you. You're here on purpose. Yes, you are. Your life was purpose. And because the God I serve doesn't make mistakes, glory to be to God. If your life did not have purpose, you would not have presence. Glory to God. You wouldn't even be here if God hadn't purposed you to be here. So you just erase that from your mind. Reject it in the name of Jesus. Now Paul learned that, but Paul also learned something else here, and he learned that Timothy was timid and he was insecure. He's timid and he's insecure because of his youth. Glory to God. So if Paul was to turn his son in the faith loose to herald the gospel and carry out the demands of pastoral ministry, he had to deal with these two most important character issues that Timothy had. issues that inevitably held him back in life and in ministry. The first character issue, I just said it a moment ago, he was timid. Mm-hmm. He was apprehensive about his call. He was stutter-stepping in ministry. Paul had to remind him. He said that I know your grandmother and what your mother taught you. You see, Eunice and Lois, they taught you the word, and they exhibited Christian faith before you, how to live the life. So Timothy was going to have to take personal responsibility to live a life of learning and continuous communion with God through Christ Jesus. Paul was saying to Timothy, although your grandmother and your mother put some good stuff in you, it's up to you to work out what they worked in you. So Paul told him, you got to be diligent to present yourself approved to God, a worker that needeth not be ashamed, rightly dividing the word of truth. He said, you got to stir up the gift of God that is in you. When I put my hands on you, you receive the Spirit of God. And you've got to understand something, Timothy, in your timid state. Understand, God has not given you the spirit of fear, but of power and of love and of a sound mind. You're timid, but you're also insecure. And so Paul deals with that issue, and he tries to combat that insecurity by letting him know that age is just a number. Y'all better pray up in here with me. He said, let nobody despise your youth, but be an example to believers in word, in conduct, in love, in spirit, in faith, and in purity. Can I translate that for you? Can I give it back to you? Oh, bless his name. All Paul is trying to tell him is, age is just a number. The anointing doesn't have an age limit on it. A Christian witness doesn't have an age on it. Oh, blessed be the name of God. Your Christian walk, you can walk the walk of a Christian and it has nothing to do with your age. You can be a witness for Christ. And you don't have an age limit, or there's an age that you got to start, because your anointing, hallelujah, doesn't have an age limit on it. And let that be a lesson to our young people who are under the sound of my voice today, to every child of God under the sound of my voice today. When it comes to being a disciple of the Lord Jesus Christ and flowing in your God-given anointing, you got to understand that age ain't nothing but a number. So if you are in the Lord, if you are a disciple of the Lord Jesus Christ, when it comes to being a disciple of the Lord Jesus Christ and flowing in your anointing, no matter how old you are, every one of us must ask the Lord to teach us to number our days, that we might apply our hearts unto wisdom. Each and every one of us must remember the Lord, our God, our Creator, in the days of our youth, before the evil days come and the years draw nigh, when we will say, I have no delight in them. You've got to understand that you've got to serve the Lord until the day you die. On an earlier occasion, Paul had Timothy to be circumcised so that he wouldn't have any problem by the Jews, but especially those who knew of his Greek paternity. So in essence, like any good father, Paul strived to remove any barriers as he could for Timothy to ensure his success in the Lord. And shouldn't that be our major goal? As parents, as mentors, as guardians, shouldn't that be our goal? Isn't that the job of every parent, to remove as many barriers and stumbling blocks and hindrances and as many amassed piles of debris that we can from the paths of our children, so that they can navigate their lives around and away from some of the very challenges that we face, some of the very circumstances that we face, so that they can ultimately do better than we did in their lives?
understand what Paul did. So we've got to understand that before the curtain closes on our lives, we've got work to do to make sure the pathway is clear for our children to be able to live a better life in Christ than we did. So that when the curtain closes, we can be like the Apostle Paul and say, I am ready to be offered, and the time of my departure is at hand. I have fought the good fight. I have finished my course. I have kept the faith. Henceforth is laid up for me a crown of righteousness. And if I might be able, if you would allow me to read between the lines, all Paul is saying, I can now pass the baton on to you. So that you can run on in Jesus' name. My sisters and brothers, I praise God for 33 years in ministry now, and for the sons and daughters that God has given me along the way. Some were completely raw materials and had to be constructed and had to be shaped and molded as well as converted. But others were like clay and only needed to be placed on the wheel, and the wheel spin around and you go ahead and you form them and shape them. Then you bake them and glaze them. Are y'all with me? That's what it was like for the Apostle Paul. Timothy was already infused with the faith because of his grandmother and his mother. And more importantly, as his father in the ministry, Paul saw in Timothy what Timothy couldn't see in himself. Paul not only believed in Timothy, but more importantly, Paul believed in the God who called Timothy and the God who resides in Timothy. How many of you got a Paul in your life? How many of you have a Paulette in your life? Hello? Understand from the text. From the text. Eunice and Lois were more than likely converted on Paul's first trip to Lystra. This means that Timothy was not only a first generation Christian, but he's also a third generation saint of God. Uh-huh. His grandmother Lois is the first generation. His mama Eunice is the second generation, which makes Timothy the third generation. Oh, somebody's awake with me today. The faith was passed on. A love for reading the word was passed on to Timothy. Are y'all still with me? Parents, guardians, mentors, what are you passing on to your children? Yeah, we can quote Proverbs 22 and 6 all day long, train up a child in the way he should go, that when he's old he'll not depart from it. What are you training him up in? What are you imparting? What are they seeing in your life? What are they emulating? Because they emulate what they see. Are you in the building? I'm in the book. Are you imparting good or bad habits? Are you passing on respectful or disrespectful behavior? Are you passing on wisdom and knowledge or ignorance? Are you passing on healthy or unhealthy relationships and lifestyles? Are you passing on social deviancy or civil citizenship? Are you teaching them how to amass likes and followers on social media? Are you trying to teach them to make an impact and an indelible mark that cannot be erased? What are you passing on to your children? Responsibility or irresponsibility with personal finances? Are you passing on perseverance or give up spirit? Throw in the towel when you're challenged. What are you passing on? Glory to God, glory to God. What are you passing on? Because it's not only what you say that they hear and that they also repeat, but it's also what they see you do that they will do. If you a hothead, don't be surprised when you see it in them. If you a gossip, every little piece of information you get, you got to pass it on. If you smoke, you shoot up, inhale, or claim it's only a contact. Can I talk to you? That's why I didn't give you points. I just want to have a little talk with you this morning. If you cuss, fuss, and fight, if you got several men that are in your life and your kid call them uncles and you know you ain't got no brothers, oh brothers, I'm coming for you. If every lady in your life that's around your children, you say, she just a friend. Oh, baby, you. What in the world do you think you'll someday see in their lives, in the lives of your many-me's? What in the world do you see? Let me pause for a public service announcement. Glory to God, glory to God. And then we'll get back to our regularly scheduled programming. One day, I promise, I'll finish writing. God gave me another word. I was kind of tossed up between this one and another word, but I went with this one. But one day, God's going to give me the go-ahead, the green light, and the thumbs up. He gave me a word that deals with environmental and generational curses, and it's called When Enough is Enough. Yeah. We're not going to preach that one here today, but for now, I need you to understand that we've got to make sure that while our children are learning reading, writing, and arithmetic, while they're learning Spanish in Microsoft and STEM and STEAM, while they're learning to dunk like LeBron James, score touchdowns like Patrick Mahomes, hit home runs like Jordan Alvarez, putt like Tiger Woods, and ace just like Venus and Serena Williams, that while they're matriculating through different levels of the latest Nintendo Switch, PS5, Xbox 10, video games, while they are learning the latest Lil Baby rap or what Megan Thee Stallion is spitting, while they're learning to dance and do the moves that they see on Red Bull's dance show style competition, or the latest move that they see on somebody's TikTok video, y'all better pray up in here. We got to remember. We got to teach the children about the Christian faith and the word of God, so that God's word will be a lamp unto their feet and a light unto their pathway. Oh, I'm preaching better than y'all hollering up in here. We got to teach them the word of God, because the Bible says that wisdom is the principal thing. Therefore, get wisdom, and with all thy getting, get. I got some Bible readers. What a tragic life they will have if they lived through all their lives and they've gained the whole world and they've lost their soul. Learn how to move money and make money and so forth, but they flunk out at Eternal Life 101. What a tragedy to know all worldliness but not know the creator of the world. What a tragedy it is if they gain the whole world and lose their soul. What a tragedy. That's why we've got to keep the word of God and the God of the word ever before our children. We can't afford to send them to school and not bring them to Sunday school. We cannot send them to the Boys and Girls Club and not require their attendance at church. We can't afford to only take them to basketball practice and football practice and not drive them to choir rehearsal or to other youth ministry functions. And we cannot teach them to take a day off from church when we're teaching them to pray all day and all night. The angels are watching over me. That don't even go together. That don't even go together. How do we teach them? How do we forgo teaching them about God, but we're talking about angels watching over me, my Lord? Can you hear me now? Can you hear me now? Now no one knows what happened to Timothy's father. Nobody knows if he was dead or if he left one day for a pack of cigarettes and just never came back. And why we don't know if he was like many fathers who have told their children, get up and go to church with your mama. We do know that the family all lived together at one time and his father was not a believer. Let me stop right there, because when I was reading the text and how Paul was talking about his father being Greek and his mother being a Jew who was converted to Christianity, even though daddy was not in the house, even though daddy was not instrumental in helping him to be converted and to learn about God, even though daddy had no idea of what the Shema is about. Hello. That's where in the Old Testament, in the book of Deuteronomy, the fathers were the ones responsible for passing the faith on to their children. Even though daddy didn't do that, Paul still celebrates Timothy, because even though one of his parents rejected God, he got it from his mama. And my sisters and brothers, while the two-parent household may seem ideal, it's not everybody's reality. And for some reason, my sisters and brothers, it's for that reason that I feel that we need to shout out Timothy's mother right there. Even though Eunice may have made poor relationship decisions when it came to her choice of mates, but when it came to her soul's salvation, she made the right decision. Hello, somebody. And while households of today may have varied parental units and it may not be perfect in our eyes, I bless every household. I thank God for every household that's raising healthy, whole, saved children. Children that are destined to impact and change the world for better. My sisters and brothers, Timothy's father was a Greek, and more than likely only Lois and Eunice and Timothy got saved. So for all intent and purposes, it seems like Timothy grew up in a fatherless household. But even though that's the way it appeared, we've got to give his mama and his grandmama another shout out. Even though daddy wasn't there, at no time did they ignore the presence of God the Father. Oh, y'all didn't get that. Y'all didn't get that. Amen. Even though they didn't have, there was no father in the household, at no time did they deny the presence of God the Father. Glory to God. Glory to God. I need to press on. I need to press her on. While Timothy's dad was not around, thank God that Eunice raised Timothy to be a man of faith. Yes. To know the word of God. And not to confuse him about being the man of the house. Do you understand the confusion that comes when a boy child is so, well, you the man of the house? You understand all the stuff that they've got to wrestle with, all the frustration that they're going through? For many men today, they're struggling with that. Can I just chew that up for you? I promise I'm only going to spend a little time for this. He had to forego, if he had been told he's the man of the house, that means he's got to forego his childhood. That means he has to feel like he's got to become the protector of the household and the environment. That means he's got to feel like he's got to be the man that God, that mama expects, though he's never seen a real man. That means that mama tells him that he's the man, but he can't work. Mama supports him and his siblings. He loves her, but his mind is messed up, because even though she's calling him the man of the house, he'll never be her man. Hmm. If mama gets involved with somebody, here's some more complexity and confusion. He feels compelled to remind the man that comes into the house that he's the man, that he loves his mama, and you can't raise your voice to my mama. You better not raise your hand to my mama. And don't you forget it, you're not my daddy. Do you understand the frustration? Do you understand the complexity of telling a young boy that you're the man of the house? If mama gets involved with somebody, he feels obligated to always put him in check, expecting from mama's new man what nobody expects to get out of him. And when a young man finally gets involved with somebody because he's been told that he's a man, but he's never seen a man, he doesn't know what it means to be a priest, a provider, or a protector. He's not going to work, or he'll often be in between jobs because mama didn't expect him to work when he was a little boy and she was calling him little man. He'll fuss and fight and even get physically violent at the time when he has a woman of his own, and he'll fight and he'll fuss with her because he couldn't fight and fuss with mama. Yeah. All right. And he'll sit around and watch videos, play video games, and eat cereal all day while his woman works like a dog. Yeah. Why? Because he was told he's the man of the house. I'm so glad that Eunice and Lois never told Timothy, you the man of the house. But they taught him instead how to be a man of God. Even though the house was fatherless, I'm so glad that God brought Paul in the nick of time. Paul was able to sow something into Timothy's life. Let me tell you about the importance of having mentors. That Paul was a pace setter for Timothy. In all of our lives, we need three mentors. We need a pace setter, a peer, and a protege. Paul had Barnabas, he had Epaphroditus, and he had Timothy as his protege. We've all got to have somebody who pours into us. We've all got to have somebody who's like iron sharpening iron. We've all got to have somebody that we can pour into. My sisters and my brothers, Paul took him back to his roots. Paul reminded Timothy of Lois and Eunice's parenting and spiritual nurture, as well as the gifts that God had already placed in him. Then he made every effort to encourage and bring out of Timothy everything that was in Timothy. And that was with them, and just what was in Timothy, glory to God, everything that he got from his grandmama and everything that he got from his mama, everything that he got from Lois and Eunice. Well, looking at the clock, I see it's about that time. And I know it's not Mother's Day. I know there's some great fathers that are under the sound of my voice who have made significant sacrifices and contributions for the lives of their sons and daughters as well. And I'll preach about fathers next Sunday, but for right now, can I get some sons and daughters to give God praise for grandmothers and mothers? I'll preach about fathers next Sunday, but can I get some brothers and sisters in the house who will thank God for everything that you got from your mama? Can I tell you what I got from my grandmama? Can I tell you what I got from my mama? Mama and grandmama taught me how to be a gentleman. They taught me how to strive for excellence. They told me about manners and etiquette. They taught me about healthy hygiene practices. They taught me when somebody does something for you, you say thank you. They taught me how to ensure that when I told somebody I was going to do something, that my word was my bond. They taught me the golden rule, to do unto others what I wanted them to do unto me. They taught me the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as
as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. They taught me the 23rd Psalm, and I'm not going to quote the whole thing, because all you really need to say is, the Lord is my shepherd. Hallelujah. They taught me how when I get up in the morning, I need to thank God for opening my eyes to see a brand new day. But before I close my eyes at night, I need to say, now I lay me down to sleep. I pray the Lord my soul to keep. If I should die before I wake, I pray the Lord my soul to take. They taught me that I can depend on God. They taught me to count my many blessings, name them one by one. Well, Paul reminded Timothy, you got your faith from your grandmother and your mother. Paul reminded Timothy, you got your knowledge of scripture from your grandmother and your mother. He reminded Timothy, you learned how to sing the songs and the songs unto God from your grandmother and your mother. You got your holy walk and your holy talk from your grandmother and your mother. You fell in love with God because you got it from your grandmother and your mother. You came to receive Christ as your personal Lord and Savior because you got it from your mama. Paul said, I had something to work with. In my son in the ministry, I had something to work with. He wasn't raw materials. All I had to do was take him and take what was in him and place him on the potter's wheel and start to shape him and stir up the gift that was in him. I had something to work with. Because he got it from his mama. What are we passing on? What are we giving God to work with? Hello. What are we giving the church to work with? Hello. Y'all pray my strength in the Lord. Because my sisters and brothers, sometimes we send children to school and they go buck wild when they're at school. And then we act like, what did y'all do to my child? You know who you sent to school. and the same ones that you sent to school come to God's house and act buck wild and cut up. Let's put some good stuff in them. Let's put some good stuff in our children because they're worth it. They're worth it. They're worth it. My sisters and brothers, let's stand all around the church. I believe that there's someone here today that you don't know the Lord in the pardoning of your sins. And there's no reason for you to leave True Love today and not have established your relationship with the Lord Jesus Christ. You will not regret the decision that you make today. I want to encourage you today to step out in the aisle today and come to the Lord just the way you are.
Don't worry about who's standing next to you, who's sitting behind you, who may be in front of you. Don't worry about any of that. This is between you and the Lord. You know what Big Mama told you. You know what Grandma told you. You know what Mama told you. You know what they put in you. You know how they taught you the scriptures, how you got a little cold and a little fever and they put some anointing oil on you and pray for you. It's in you. But now it's your responsibility and your time to take responsibility for your walk with the Lord Jesus Christ. Is there one today? Come to the Lord just the way you are. Well, preacher, that's not my call today. I started my walk and I've stumbled and I've fallen. But I need to rededicate my life to the Lord Jesus Christ. If you hear the Spirit of God talking to you today, won't you please come rededicate your life to Jesus?
My will I give.
Preacher, that's not my call either. But I don't have a home church. I want you to know that the search is over.
Use me, love.
I want to be your pastor. We want to be your church family. If you need to come, if you desire to come, just step out into the aisle. Step out into the aisle and come forward. Give me your hand and give the Lord Jesus Christ your heart. You're in a place today where you can be fed the word of God. Amen. Come on, encourage her. Encourage her. She needs to feel you. She needs to feel your encouragement. Come on, bless God in this place today. Is there another today? God bless you. Is there another today?
Lord,
Jesus said, if you be ashamed of me before men, I shall be ashamed of you before my Father in heaven. Come to the Lord today. Come to him just the way you are. Amen. Amen. Thank you, sound booth. Won't you come today? Come if you desire to be saved. Come if you desire to rededicate your life to the Lord. And come if you don't have a home church. Now I need you to go to work with me, church. Amen. True love, go to work. Amen. Ask that person standing beside you or behind you, ask them first of all, are you saved? If they say anything other than yes, say, I'll come walk with you. Amen. That may have been the wrong neighbor. Turn on the other side. Say, are you saved?
To you.
And if they tell you anything other than yes, say, come on, I'll walk with you today. Hallelujah. Tell, I ain't scared. I'll walk with you.
Lord.
Amen, amen. As that person again, so I know you're saved, but do you have a home church? Do you have a church family? Again, if they say anything other than yes, say, I'll walk with you today.
I give.
Hallelujah. Amen. If you're not coming, go ahead and take your seat.
I'll do what you say do. Use me, love. To show someone the way.
Hallelujah.
And enables me to say, oh,
hallelujah. My story is my story.
My story is empty. And I am available.
Hallelujah. Sister Sherry.
Good afternoon to Dr. Hemphill and True Love family. I bring to you today, as I say your name, please stand. I have Joanne Walker, Christian Experience.
Bless you. Bless you. Welcome.
And we also have joining us today, Lindsay Harrington for rededication.
Praise the Lord. God bless you. God bless you. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Amen. Amen. I anoint you now in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. I anoint you now in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. And I want you to understand today the reason why they're clapping. Because we're excited that you're home. that you came home today. Hallelujah.
And I
true love is blessed today because you came home.
My story.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen. True love, would you extend your hands towards these who are our family members? Amen. Extend your hands towards them. Welcome home. We're so glad you're here. We're glad you heard the Lord today. We are so excited about you, about the gifts that you bring, and the gift that you are. Thank you for coming to grow with us and to love out loud. Let's pray. Father, in the name of Jesus, I pray for these, my sisters, right now, oh God, in the name of Jesus. I pray, Lord God, that you will pour your spirit upon them. Oh God, pour your spirit out upon their flesh. Fill them, Lord God, with your spirit, your anointing, oh God. Increase them in their gifts, oh God, in the name of Jesus. Help them to find their rightful place, Lord God, in the body of Christ, where they can help us to advance the kingdom of God. Father God, in the name of Jesus, we praise you, Lord God, for these, our two new sisters. We praise you, God, and we understand that the way we treat the gift reflects how we feel about the giver. And because we honor you, because we love you, because we celebrate you, we celebrate them. In the name of Jesus Christ, amen and amen. Come on, encourage them. Encourage them.
Available. My storage is empty. And I am available to you.
Hallelujah.
Well, I am Makaya, bringing you our weekly announcements. Hey, True Love, I am Makaya, bringing you our weekly announcements.
Another thing that you need to value about him having a place at the table and see this as God speaking into your spirit is, my sisters and brothers, whether there's a tablecloth at the table or there's not a tablecloth at the table, when I'm sitting at the table, you can only see me from here up. Oh, y'all didn't get that. Y'all didn't get that. That means when you table. Yeah. Nobody can see what's going on under the table. Y'all gonna pray up in here. They can't see what's going on under the table. Even though I may be crippled at the table, the evidence is always under. That's what you say to me. That's how you treat me. Because I'm sick. Places I used to go, but now I'm at the table.
Your financial statement, please complete the financial statement request form and place it in the offering bin. When completing your form, please be sure to print clearly. True Love, we thank you for your faithful and generous giving. Because of your giving, we as a church are able to carry out the vision and work of True Love. When you request, please be sure to state your name, address, phone number, email, and how you would like to receive your document in either mail, in person, or email. True Love, in honor of Black History Month,
our youth department will be having their Southern Dessert and Treat fundraiser. If you're interested in any Southern desserts or treats, please see us in the fellowship hall immediately after service. Hey family, please join us next Sunday for our Go Red for Women. Please come show up in your all red attire. Join us February 22nd for Ash Wednesday service. We will also begin our 40-day fast at 7 p.m. that night. The UNLV Upward Bound Math and Science Center is seeking professionals to perform mock interviews for their Spring Career Day. This will take place on Saturday, February 25th. Lunch will be provided from 12 p.m. to 1 p.m., and mock interviews will be from 1:15 p.m. to 3 p.m. If you have any questions, please contact UNLV UBMSC office at 702-895-4777. No Menthol May will be sponsoring a movie night here in the sanctuary on Saturday, February 25th at 6 p.m. Come out and be sure to bring the entire family for a great night of fellowship. True Love Youth and Family, Live for Christ Bible Study will resume Monday, February 27th at 7 p.m. via Zoom. If you have any questions, please download our Ministry One app to be in tune or contact the youth leader.
The 58th Selma Bridge Crossing Jubilee. Remembering your vote is your freedom. Join this reenactment march with Las Vegas Alumni Chapter of Delta Sigma Theta Sorority Incorporated and NAACP standing with the Selma Jubilee Coordinating Committee on March 5th at 11 a.m. beginning at New Jerusalem Worship Center.
True Love, Minister Will Deep and Sis Lolita McCoy moved to California in January. Please remember them in your prayers and congratulate them on their new journey.
True Love needs you. If you would like to get connected and serve within a ministry, please complete a ministry connection card and place it in the offering basket. Ministry connection cards are located in the front vestibule.
To stay connected with what's happening here at True Love, download our mobile app by downloading the Ministry One app and searching for True Love. This will give you access to all announcements, events, past sermons, and so much more.
You can also follow us on our website at www.truelovenbclv.com and follow our other social media platforms.
Family, as always, let's continue to keep our sick and shut and bereavement families in our prayers. Here's something to think about. Don't pray to God for an easy life. Pray for the strength to be able to accept, handle, and conquer anything that comes your way.
Thank you for worshiping with us. Have a blessed week, and remember to love out loud.
Amen, amen, amen. I'm not trying to prolong service, but there are a couple persons who needed prayer. Before we leave here, we are the family of God, and we want to pray for those family members that are here that are going to have medical procedures or they're going through illness or bereavement right now. You saw some of the names that were on the board. We have Deacon Lacey, who lost his brother. He's actually on his way to, he's on his way today to New Orleans. Reverend and Sister Sheila Dixon are at home. Reverend Dixon is taking care of his wife. Amen. She's sick. We praise God. Oh, got it. I missed one. Sister Pope is here, and amen. We want to praise God for her and for God, what he did in her life. Amen. She and her husband were in a car accident this past week, hit by a diesel. I anoint you in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. And God spared her life. Amen. The truck. Is all right with me? All right. The truck hit the car on her side. And she's here to talk about it. I don't know why y'all quiet. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen. I used to be slow. Amen. I used to be slow and not know when to give God praise, but that's a miracle right there. Amen. And so we praise God for them. Amen. We got a few other brothers that are here. Amen. That we know that we're praying for you, sir. Amen. Amen. Let us look to God in prayer. Amen. And if by chance you're another brother or sister who needs prayer, just slip your hand in the air. Amen. God knows what you need. God knows what you're going through. Amen. And because of that, even though I didn't come around and anoint you, we just believe that you're in the presence of God and his anointing power is present to heal you. Father, you've been so faithful to us all the days of our lives. Lord God, we're going through some stuff right now. And Father, we know that we're here. We're present today. We're under the gaze of God only because you've spared our lives. Because you've sustained our lives. You've met our every need, Lord God, and we thank you for it. God, I pray for every hand that's been slipped in the air. And maybe, Lord God, the brother or sister doesn't have the strength to do it. But I praise you right now that you know, Lord God, what the situation is in their lives. We also, Lord God, add, Deacon and Sister Winslow, Lord God, to this prayer as well. Father God, we add Deacon McKeever to this prayer as well. Father God, in the name of Jesus, God, I praise you because I've seen what you have been able to do. I know what you will do. And I know, Lord God, that you are able. I praise you, Lord God, and I pray that, Lord God, you will touch Deacon Banks, Lord God, through what he's going to go through this week. I pray, Lord God, that you will heal Deacon Boyce, Lord God, in the name of Jesus. We pray, Lord God, that you will continue to touch the life and the body, Lord God, of Deacon in training, Percy Sutton. Father God, all of your children this day that are here under the sound of my voice, God, you've been faithful. You can do anything and everything but fail. Lord God, heal where there's money dilemmas. Heal, Lord God, where there's something sickness in their bodies right now. Father God, heal, Lord, where there's brokenness in their lives right now. God, we turn to you because, Lord God, we've searched all over and we found that there's none like you. None like you in all the earth. And God, I pray right now for every person that's praying for another brother or sister under the sound of my voice. Lord God, while you're blessing them, while you're making a way for them, make a way, Lord God, and let some drops fall on us as well. So that, Lord God, we won't just have a response or a reaction or goosebumps, Lord God, but Lord God, our souls will cry out hallelujah just because you are God. And God, our souls cry out hallelujah right now in advance. We pray for Traveling Mercy, for Deacon and Sister Lacey, Lord God. We pray, Father, that you'll be with that family during this time. And Father God, wherever there's brokenness because of bereavement or grief, death, Lord God, we pray for your healing power to be there as well. Console and comfort in Jesus' name. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. My sisters and brothers, this week, amen. Let me start here. Ash Wednesday. On Wednesday, we will have an Ash Wednesday service here. We're having worship on Wednesday. We're also going to have anointing with oil on that night. That is the beginning of our fast. This is also the beginning where we will be coming to God and confessing our sins and asking God to forgive us as we repent. Amen. And the journey begins on Wednesday for Holy Season. Amen. We should always be in repentance anyway. Amen. Praise the name of God. We also want to let you know that on Friday, our praise dancers, amen, Imani Worship Arts Ministry has been invited to come to Findlay Middle School to present for Black History Month. They're going to minister for the Community Expo on this Friday from 5 to 8 o'clock p.m. And amen. They didn't just call any dance troupe or ensemble, but they called the people of God. Amen. And so please be in prayer for them. It's a free event. So if you're able to be there, it's at 333 West Tropical Parkway. Again, the school is Findlay Middle School. So you can Google that. Amen. Amen. Please support our youth ministry today, Lit for Christ. Amen. They are presenting. They have Southern Desserts. Amen. They're asking for small donations. Amen. That is in the fellowship hall. Please go and support our youth ministry. Amen. Amen. Even if you're an extra sweet person like me and you can't eat the desserts, at least bless them with a donation. Amen. Amen. Praise God. And then on Saturday, we're having movie night here at True Love. That's 6 p.m. Amen. So please be here for movie night. Would you please come, Lamar? Amen. Brother Lamar Bolden has finished his new member class. Praise the Lord. Thank you. Thank you. Praise God. This certificate of membership presented to Raymond Lamar Bolden. You have publicly confessed Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, and you've been received in the full membership of the True Love Missionary Baptist Church. Hallelujah. Amen. Will our deacons please come and shake his hand and bless? Oh, yeah, you come right here. Amen. Amen. We're going to shake your hand, bless you, get a right hand of fellowship. God bless you. Great. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Has not God moved in this place today? Hallelujah. Let's give God praise. Hallelujah. Amen. For each and every one of you, my Father's children, we give God praise. Good to see Reverend Riley. Amen. Amen. In the house today. And Kente. Amen. Representing. And all of you, my Father's children, we are so grateful to God for each and every one of you. Let us now stand all around the church. You are the source of my strength.
You are the source of my strength.
God bless you.
Oh. You are
praying hard every
day. The strength of my life. Oh, I lift my hands in total praise to you.
God of our weary years, God of our silent tears, thou who has led us thus far on the way, thou who has by thy might led us into the light, keep us forever in the path, we pray. Lest our feet stray, our God, from the places where we met thee, Lest our hearts, drunk with the wine of the world, we forget thee. Shadowed beneath thy hand, may we forever stand true to our God and true to our native land. In Jesus' name, go in peace. Amen.